Hey explorers, Brian here. So, what do three countries which share only a total of 332 miles of borders have in common? Well, as we travel to a trio of territories in our lesson today, we'll find out. Our lesson objectives are to describe Turkey, Iran, and Cyprus and their physical features, governments, and cultural traditions, compare and contrast life in a secular country with one that has a government based on religion, and identify common threads that link these three countries. Oh yeah, and there's a hot air balloon ride. Excited yet? Come float away with me and let's get a bird's eye view of our final Southwest Asian countries. Overview. Cyprus is an island in the Mediterranean Sea, just south of Turkey and west of Syria. Turkey, yep, you know it from the Europe unit, is surrounded by the Black Sea on the north, the Mediterranean Sea on the southwest, and the Fertile Crescent on the southeast. Iran is on the eastern side of the Fertile Crescent, with the Caspian Sea to the north, and the Persian Gulf and the Gulf of Oman to the south. So you may be wondering, why are these countries grouped together? There are some common threads. For example, they are all on the outer fringes of the Fertile Crescent, and they all share some ancestral links. Now, let's investigate further. Physical characteristics. We'll begin with the smallest member of our trio. Cyprus is a warm, dry island in the eastern Mediterranean Sea that, like Turkey, could be considered both European and Asian. This island, about 50% larger than Delaware, is dominated by two mountain ranges, the Troodos in the south and the Chaeronea in the north. At 302,000 square miles, Turkey is 85 times larger than Cyprus and occupies the Anatolian Peninsula. Aside from coastal areas, it's predominantly mountainous. The highest peak, Mount Ararat, reaches 16,945 feet. The Bosporus Strait divides Europe and Asia, and Turkish territory lies on both sides. The famed Tigris and Euphrates rivers originate in eastern Turkey, which, further south, gave rise to the ancient Mesopotamian civilization. Most of Turkey's nearly 5,000 miles of coastline features a Mediterranean climate, though along the Black Sea, it can be quite rainy. Meanwhile, when you float over the interior of Turkey, including here in scenic Cappadocia, famous for its hot air balloon rides, you will experience a continental climate that features more extreme temperatures, both hot and cold. At over 636,000 square miles, Iran is more than twice the size of Turkey. It contains a central desert plateau surrounded by a ring of mountain ranges. Toward the coast, the altitude descends sharply. The rugged Zagros Mountains form a natural boundary with Iraq and Turkey, and along the Caspian Sea runs the Elburz Mountains, which contain Mount Damavand, Iran's tallest peak at 18,605 feet. Beneath the surface of Iran, the Eurasian and Arabian tectonic plates converge, resulting in violent earthquakes. Since 1900, there have been 14 quakes with magnitudes of 7 or higher. Let's consider this question. What preventive measures can be taken to protect people from the damaging effects of earthquakes? Please pause while you record your answer in the lesson PDF. Iran has a diverse climate which is dependent on altitude and proximity to water. Generally, the winter is very rainy, producing flooding in some areas, while summer is quite dry. On the northern coast, near the Caspian, the Elburz Mountains trap humidity year-round and contribute to a lush subtropical zone. The people. Turkey and Iran are each home to over 80 million people, while tiny Cyprus has only 1.2 million. About 75% of the populations of Turkey and Iran are urbanized, with Iran experiencing tremendous urban growth since 1950. About 15 million people live in Istanbul, Turkey, while 8.6 million reside in Tehran, the capital of Iran. Lifespans are rather long in each country, with the birth rate in Turkey and Iran slightly higher than the European and Central Asian average. Each country is projected to make modest gains in population by 2050, before the curve levels off. Ethnicity and Religion. Now we get to explore some of those common threads. Historically, the Persian Empire dominated Iran, and Persian remains the largest ethnic group there. The Persian language, known as Farsi, continued to be spoken there even after the Arab invasions around the 7th century CE. Today, nearly all Iranians are Muslim. 90% practice Shia Islam, while just 10% are Sunni, a reversal of the world's vastly Sunni Muslim demographic. Farsi is spoken by around half of the population, and a significant minority group called the Kurds occupies the mountainous Kurdistan region, which spans both Iran and Turkey. Most of Turkey's population can trace its roots to the Turkic peoples. Turkish is the primary language, followed by Kurdish. And, like Iran, over 90% of the population is Muslim. Cyprus was settled by Greek colonists in about 1200 BCE. 80% of Cypriots speak Greek and largely practice Greek Orthodox Christianity. The other 20%, guess what? They have Turkish roots and are Muslim. Greeks and Turks have had a contentious relationship with each other ever since Greece broke off from the Ottoman Empire, based in Turkey, in 1830. Since then, Greece and Turkey have opposed each other in several major wars. Let's think. What kinds of challenges might these two groups face as they cohabit the small island of Cyprus? Please pause while you record your answer in the lesson PDF. Government and economy. As a result of reforms made by President Kemal Ataturk in the 1920s and 30s to separate Islam from the country's laws and institute European legal structures, Turkey is now a secular country. It's made more recent attempts to strengthen ties to Europe, and results have been mixed. The country is part of NATO, a military alliance between 30 member countries, mostly in Europe. Efforts to join the European Union, however, have failed. This is due at least in part to Turkey's checkered human rights record. The nation has been maligned for squashing free speech and peaceful protest. Additionally, its history of repressing the Kurds and other minority groups has drawn criticism from the European community. Iran experienced a reformation in the 1920s similar to that of Turkey. However, a 1979 revolution pushed the country away from secular Western influence and back towards traditional Islamic policies, leading to a reduction in religious tolerance. Today, the population elects the president of the Islamic Republic by popular vote. The head of state, however, is not the president, it's the supreme leader of Iran, who is not only the political but also the religious authority of the country. Cyprus is ruled by a presidential republic. However, the country has been divided since 1974 as the result of a civil war between the Greek and Turkish Cypriots. Today, the island is split between the Republic of Cyprus, the internationally recognized state, and the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, recognized only by Turkey. Despite these troubles, Cyprus, an EU member state, has a lot going for it. It is known for being a rather peaceful, democratic country with a fairly strong GDP per capita, led by tourism. And speaking of the economy, remember that hidden resource on Iran's coastline? Yep, that's oil, and lots of it. The Persian Gulf contains over half of the world's crude oil reserves. Along with natural gas, these resources help to power Iran's economy. Turkey heavily relies on agriculture, tourism, and steel production, but its economy has been plagued by inflation and debt. Turkey and Iran are both Muslim countries, so how do you think life is similar in secular Turkey and traditional Iran? How do you think it's different? Culture. Now, if you want a little slice of Turkish culture, head straight for Istanbul's Grand Bazaar, which welcomes up to 400,000 people on any given day. And no, you can't land your balloon there. There, you can find Turkish treats such as ceramics, jewelry, and their famous carpets. Then, take a break with a Turkish coffee served from a çeşme. Yep, it's so strong that you'll see the grounds in the bottom of your cup after you've finished. We mentioned carpets in Turkey. Well, Iran has something to say too. Persian rugs date back to the 5th century BCE and are also known as some of the world's finest. So now, can you see why I was referring to the common threads between these countries? floored by my jokes yet? Okay, I'll stop. I don't want to rug anyone the wrong way. Iran is also renowned for its literary and music tradition, the latter being more than just performance art, but also a spiritual expression incorporating complex music theory. And on the multicultural island of Cyprus, you can enjoy delicious food influenced by Turkish, Greek, and Southwestern Asian cuisines. Conclusion. So that does it. How did you enjoy your trip through Cyprus, Turkey, and Iran? Today you experienced an Islamic Republic, a secular Muslim-majority country that bridges two continents, and an island that is split between two ethnic groups. Yep, not your average combo of countries. We hope you enjoyed it. As we near the end of our journey through Turkey, Iran, and Cyprus, think about this review question, which you can answer in your PDF after the video. What ties exist between these nations and the rest of Southwestern Asia? What makes them unique? Well, it's time to land that balloon. Until next time, gule gule, and keep exploring. Hey!